You're listening to the What the Wrestling Podcast, the show that brings you all things wrestling with your host, RJD. Baby, WrestleMania is upon us. We have one more week to go. March has been an incredible month. We got celebrities smacking each other. We got the world making crazy memes that I shall not unsee because it's too funny. Triple H talking about what's going on with him and his health. Holy hell. Lot to get into. We are going to get into it shortly, but first, check out my socials.
You activated my trap card.
Follow me, RJD, on Instagram, RJD10K, on Twitter, RJ699, and on Snapchat. Follow What the Wrestling on Facebook and YouTube and TikTok.
Perfect.
And as always, follow me on Spotify. And Anchor.
Do it! Just do it!
Just do it, goddammit. Just do it. Listen, before we roll out, thank you for everybody for rocking with me. And we are going to keep the ball rolling. Let's go! Yes, yes, yes. Tis I, RJD, here. Welcome to What the Wrestling. Here is the podcast where we talk about all things wrestling and we talk about celebrities smacking each other over jokes. I'm just playing. We're not talking about none of that, but
nope,
it was hilarious. But we are going to get into a little bit about Triple H, talk about some Raw and SmackDown, WrestleMania. WrestleMania season is upon us. It has been upon us, but it doesn't feel like it. This is crazy. But before anything, first things first, like the goddamn video, hit that like button, like, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel, What the Wrestling. You already know, Facebook, YouTube, and TikTok. WrestleMania is upon us. We about to step the game up. We will be doing a live stream tomorrow. Look out for that. NXT review will be coming out on Wednesday. And y'all know I love my AE dub, so let's not play any more games. With that being said, thank you for everybody for rocking with me. Thank you for everybody hitting me up. Let me trying to find out what's going on as I get this computer situation situated. RJD TV is going live tonight, right, and I mean right after I finish this. So that should be fun. Who is texting me? Don't text me while I'm on the air, goddammit. What's wrong with you? So, with that being said, shout out to the Misfits. Great, great weekend with the Misfits. That was dope. More on that on my RJD TV channel on Facebook. Now, moving right along. Oof, excuse me. Let's talk about Triple H. So I have seen the video of Triple H on Stephen A. Smith's show. He talked about a couple of things. Excuse me. Talked about a couple of things. I gotta move up, man. I feel like I'm far away. Talked about a couple of things detailing his issues during his cardiac event, which is quite frankly scary as hell. He had that on Instagram. On ESPN. I said Instagram.
You stupid.
He had the interview on ESPN. It's on YouTube right now. Go check it out if you want to see what he talked about. I am going to talk about some of it here. So apparently last fall he had viral pneumonia. The brother was walking around, had some chest issues, spitting up blood, he said. I guess his wife saw and it was like, yo, hospital. So things started to look bad when they did some test results. And then they told him, F that, pack a bag, and get your ass in the hospital. And he says, I guess he had, like, fluid around his heart, which is crazy. He had a slightly enlarged, because, you know, an athlete's heart, you know, athletes have slightly enlarged heart, I guess, due to all the physical stress and activity they put on their bodies. But the brother said, like, I forget what it was called, but the way his heart was pumping, out of 100, you know, normal is like 50 to 60 in that range. His was like 22. By the time he got to the hospital, it was like 12. And then I think it went all the way down to 2 right before they started working their magic on him. And it was just, he was in full-blown heart failure, which is crazy. You would think, and he did speak on, it's like heart failure. Yes. And the crazy thing is he did speak on that his great-grandfather and his grandfather had heart issues. So it's a hereditary thing. But I think his gray and his father was all right. Excuse me. His father was all right, but his great-grandfather, I think, died in his 50s. And Triple H is in his 50s. So it's definitely something to look out for. But he just assumed, you know, I'm in good shape. I'm good. My heart doesn't hurt. Whatever. But listen, the truth is, you know, that hereditary shit you have to look out for, especially if it runs in like the males of your family. If you're women, it runs in the women of your family. There's some families I know, they have, everything is on the women's side. If you're like a woman born into a family, it like it sucks. It's like you got to live a perfect life just to, like, not have the issues that the women in your family have. You're just pre-exposed to it. And this brother, obviously, he asked, his line has heart issues. And the fact that he was going through all of that last fall was crazy. And mind you, he's got all of this going on. Vince is taking power away from him in NXT. At this time, because NXT, it wasn't 2.0 yet, but things were slowly starting to turn. And the brother almost died. He said he was on the 1 yard line. Yikes. Like, once again, on the 1 yard line. And now he's got a defibrillator in his chest. So he says, listen, as far as in ring goes, I will never wrestle again. He said, "It's, you know, it would suck to be zapped on live TV, right?"
Nope.
Absolutely not. So this is just crazy to go from, yeah, you got viral. He thought he had the Rona, but he really ended up having viral pneumonia and then going in for all of these tests and stuff, finding out you're in heart failure that fast. It's scary to think about, man. That would have sucked. That would have been crazy just to see, you know, we've had a lot of wrestling deaths last couple of years especially, and that would have been crazy to see Triple H saying that Triple H, you know, passing away. And I'm glad he's okay. I don't need to see Triple H in the ring. I think one of the last great matches he had was the match with Ronda when Ronda was at WrestleMania. Him and Steph versus Ronda and Kurt Angle. That's probably the last great match he had. And you know what? That's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. Triple H has had an illustrious career. I'm not going to give a eulogy because he's still here. So I'm not going to speak. I'm not going to use those words to speak into existence. But what I will say is the greatest thing as a fan watching that he's ever produced is NXT. Yes, he married into the family. Yes, maybe he got a little bit more opportunities that other wrestlers didn't get because he was Stephanie's husband. Okay, great. Debatable. And you might not be wrong in saying those things. But NXT, the original NXT, with all the Ring of Honor guys, the Joes and the Ricochets and the Coles and the Robert Roodes, all of these guys, Shinsuke Nakamura, all of these guys that he got from Ring of Honor and all over the world, Finn Balor, Sami Zayn, I can go on and on and on, Ember Moon, Shayna Baszler, the Pirate Princess, Asuka, and the early iterations of NXT, all the Four Horsewomen, Becky, Bayley, Sasha, and Charlotte. Say what you want about Charlotte. She's great. I don't care what nobody says. This brother has brought up those early NXT years with the takeovers just getting better and better and better and better. As you guys know who follow me, I used to say all the time, NXT never lets me down. I used to say that for a reason because it was the best wrestling show on TV, period, at one point in time. They had a good 3 or 4 year run. And the fact that he had a vision, or still has, a vision for pro wrestling that I absolutely love. I wish WWE would run their company how NXT, the first NXT, was running theirs. Johnny Gargano, Tommaso Ciampa. I could go on and on and on and on and on. I wish WWE ran like NXT ran, black and gold. I wish they had all the talent. Not like they couldn't afford to pay people. They got all this TV money. Imagine what Raw and SmackDown would look like now if half of the people that they fired in the last 2 years weren't fired and they actually used them on 4 hours of TV. Dynamite, what's wrong with me?
You stupid.
AEW has 3 hours of TV and they have a full freaking roster full of people and they use their talent way better than WWE ever used theirs. And they don't have they have a couple of hours less of TV time, but they spread the people out. We rarely see rematches. But with WWE, we see this shit every day. And they had all this talent that they didn't want to use. Oh, we can't use this guy. We can't use this guy. We got nothing for him. But Triple H managed. And I didn't watch NXT in its inception. Like some of those early takeovers, I didn't see. Even Baron Corbin, he was down there. American Alpha. So I missed a lot of that stuff. But when Shinsuke got there, I really started watching it heavy duty. Neville, a.k.a. Pac, the bastard. Like, Triple H did his thing with recruitment. And I think what I am going to be looking forward to is seeing what he does next and seeing if he ever gets an opportunity to see his vision come to life. Because I think that's the greatest thing that he's given us. And on, like I said, on the podcast, he announced it's over. Triple H announces that he shall no longer be competing in ring. And just like clockwork, WWE put out the graphic. WWE and ESPN were in side-by-side comparisons to his retirement. They put out the statement. He made the statement, and it was put out immediately. So they obviously knew that he was going to announce it, but that's fine. It's Triple H. He did well, man. Triple H, he had a very illustrious career in ring, and he's got a wonderful mind for the business, and I hope he does get to see his vision actually realized one day. That would be freaking amazing. So let's hope and let's see what happens. I mean, that's all we could do. But he made that announcement, and that was all she wrote. So, props to Triple H. I'm glad he's okay. F everything else. I'm just glad the brother is okay because he has kids. He has a wife. He loves them very much as he started to get choked up on the show. And I'm just glad that as a husband and a father that he is here and he is in relatively good health. Now, heart failure is no fucking joke. He still could very well be in heart failure. I hope he's okay and he's getting better and stronger every day. Maybe the working out will help him. I don't know, but I hope he, you know, does what he has to do and he wants to be around for him and his kids and his wife, and he's going to do what he needs to do to be around. So shout out to him. I'm just, like I said, glad he's okay. Way to kick out at 2, Triple H. Good job, brother. Good job. Now, moving on. Let's talk about AEW Dynamite this week quickly, and then we'll talk about, not Dynamite, Rampage. Let's talk about Rampage this week, and then we will quickly talk about Rampage and quickly talk about SmackDown. SmackDown was as follows. Not a lot going on here. We had Brock Lesnar there. We had Shinsuke versus Jey Uso. Nakamura looked good. Fighting from behind. Uso, crisp as always. Jey, much respect to Jey. When Jimmy left and he got hurt, Jey really shined as always. They had a distraction as always, but this kicked off the show, and you know, Brock was backstage just chilling, waiting for Roman, as always. So, nothing wrong there. So, this was good. Good stuff, nothing wrong here. Brock waited for Roman, kept it moving. We had Kofi versus Ridge Holland. Best thing here is Xavier Woods is back. So, that's the best thing that happened all night. Mr. Woods came back, so it is good to see Mr. Woods back. I know he's been hit with the injury bug a couple of times, so I hope he stays healthy here. It just sucks that he had to miss some time, and it sucks that when he comes back, Big E gets hurt, because you never want to see anybody, you know, get hurt the way Big E did, but this is basically what happened. So, after Shinsuke beat Jey, I guess I'll just finish it out like this. We had Drew McIntyre promising to wipe the floor with Happy Corbin at WrestleMania. Definitely had a bell. He had a backstage interview with Kayla Braxton as well. We had a video package talking about Corbin's rough 2021 and the bounce back that he had. And all the money that he has, good for him. Corbin and Madcap Moss were excited to embarrass Mr. Drew McIntyre at WrestleMania. We'll see if that happens. As I said, Xavier Woods came back and beat Ridge Holland. Wrap it up for a small package. Woods is officially back. And good to see him back as always. Ronda called out Charlotte, but Ronda needs to start talking. Ronda needs to stop talking like this. You know what your problem is, Charlotte? When I beat you, if you beat me, it'll be the best thing that you've ever done in your entire career. But when I beat you, it's going to be relatively easy, light work. She needs to, I don't know if it's like, you must talk from the heart, Ronda. You're not talking from the heart.
Stop the cap.
So I don't believe you.
Fuck this.
I don't believe you. So, it's almost like she's talking, but she's not using her studio voice. Like, you got to project. She got to use her microphone voice. She's very monotone. You know what your problem is, Charlotte? So, it's like, she's got the mannerisms down and the intensity, but she's got to get down the promo work. Maybe she should go back to working with Heyman. I don't know. But she's got to get better at that. Charlotte was on the Titantron. Ronda was there live. Like I said, they had a good back and forth. And she's going to add a limb to her trophy collection. So we'll see what happens. Angel Garza beat Ricochet. Humberto Carrillo grabbed Ricochet, so he got counted out. So he has earned himself a future title shot. I really wish they would hate.
Respect my authority.
Stop doing matches like this and just let the people earn the matches. Like, why are you beating the champion so somebody can earn a match? I know that's their policy. That's their the way they do things. But to me, it's very dumb. Like, if you want Carrillo to get a title shot, have him beat a couple of people and get a title shot. Like, what are we doing here?
How dare you?
Anyway, Sami Zayn boasted about how badly he was going to beat Johnny Knoxville at WrestleMania. Austin Theory taunted Pat McAfee. Pat McAfee then tried to get into Vince's office, but he could not. Sasha Banks beat Queen Zelina, Rhea Ripley, and Shayna Baszler. Where, cool spot here, we had a double bank statement. That was pretty cool. Double backstabber. But ultimately, she beat her with the bank statement, and that was all she wrote. WWE announces the Andre the Giant Battle Royal for next week's SmackDown, even though it normally has taken place at WrestleMania. They are, I guess, they're clearing room for the other shit in the show. And I mean, this could have been something that makes people, but they don't use it to make anybody. It's like Cesaro, they could have used it for him. Big Show, they could have used it for him, but they didn't really propel anybody, which is crazy, because you have a battle royal like that, you want it to mean something, but they've never used it to propel anyone, which is dumb, because they could, but they don't. So,
shots fired! Shots fired!
Yes, shots fired. But as for the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal, basura. So, Lesnar, at the end of the show, Roman came, went to do his segment. Lesnar came, he went, told them to acknowledge me, as he always does. Talked his shit. Brock Lesnar was back there. Brock Lesnar said, all right, I'm coming out there. He beat up his car, smashed his car. He said, listen, I got like 4 or 5 of them shits. Like, I don't care about that. So he came out with the chair after throwing away the pickaxe. Comes down here, comes from the crowd, which is very smart, finally. Finally, somebody does something right so he can't get ambushed. Comes from the crowd, and security comes out, and Roman sends the security out and said, you'll never get to me. And then Brock Lesnar picked up in the chair and proceeded to beat the holy shit out of 15 security guards. I'm sure their backs all hurt today, a week later, but they'll be okay. Oh, man, that was funny. Then, after he beat them up, he gets in the ring, but the Usos come in, get Roman out of there, and Brock Lesnar still breaking shit, beating up on security still, so sucks to be them. Imagine having that gig, huh? Yeah, it sucks to be you. So, after that, Roman goes out there and says, listen, I'm going to be the Universal WWE Champion, me alone.
The lie detector determined.
That's definitely happening. So, we'll see what happens. That's how SmackDown went off the air. It was not that great. Not a video packages, but you know what? It is what it is. It is what it is. The build has been weak, very weak. They need to do better. They need to do better with the builds. The builds are fucking horrible. They're bad, and they need to listen. If you're gonna build to some shit like this, just build to it. Like, stop it with the nonsense. So we'll see what happens. That's all I could do. But I'm not liking this build. Like, WrestleMania is supposed to be WrestleMania season. Holy shit, look at what's going on. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. But instead, WrestleMania season is just, like, blah. Like, that's the best way I can put it. So, I don't know. I mean, they only got a fucking week left, so it's kind of a wrap. But I wish they did a better job of building this year, because this build sucks. That's really all I can say. This build sucks. So we have the Revolution is televised. Rampage, goddammit. Rampage was really good, as always.
Just bring it, bitch!
We started off with Dustin Rhodes versus Lance Archer. Lance Archer beat the holy hell out of him. This was competitive, but Rhodes got the win, which shocked the shit out of me. He got the win, but Lance Archer beat the holy hell out of him for the beatdown post-match. He does have a ruptured eardrum, so I hope he is okay. We'll see what happens. But I think he's still rolling with Dan Lambert. So I don't know what's going on. Lance Archer shouldn't be losing to Dustin Rhodes, but that's what they did. So if you're gonna do a beatdown like that, I guess it fits Lance Archer, but Lance Archer loses a lot of big matches, so that sucks. Then we had the Dark Order versus Red Dragon. Red Dragon gets the win here, and they proceed to beat the holy hell out of the Dark Order. We had Allen Angels and Ten. They beat them up, and Jungle Boy and Luchasaurus came in and made the save. Fish and O'Reilly got the hell out of Dodge. This was a decent match. Red Dragon had them in full effect. This probably could have been better if it was on Dynamite. All four of these guys are excellent at what they do. Allen Angel's underrated. Ten is underrated too. And we'll see what they do with these guys moving forward. But I'm telling you, these guys can all wrestle. But it was, a fairly decent match. Fuego del Sol came out and said the people gave him strength and the people helped him out, even though he's like Owen. He was like Owen forever. And he's not afraid of the House of Black, and he's ready for a fight. So the House of Black, the lights went out and they showed up and they proceeded to beat the holy shit out of him. Buddy Matthews beat him up. Then he got kicked. He got kneed in the face. I think he got kneed in the face by Aleister Black. Brody King then hit him with a razor's edge sort of move. And they beat the shit out of him and then left him there in a pile of death and destruction. Those guys are awesome. Dark Order then came down and challenged the House of Black. And they will be facing the House of Black with Fuego del Sol. And they are going to get killed, but that's okay.
Give me a hell yeah!
The House of Black is amazing. I don't even care what they do, because whatever they do is great. We had Nyla Rose versus Maddie Rakowski. Squash match. Thanks for coming. See you later. Really didn't need this. She beat her in less than a minute. She hit her with the Beast Bomb. Even though they said she was trained by Thunder Rosa, she got her ass kicked. Then we had QT Marshall bringing out this thing for Hook. This Hook appreciation bullshit. And Hook came out straight face. Used the other guy's head to break said mantle. Walked back up. Danhausen was trying to curse him, but he just said, "Who the fuck are you?" and kept it moving.
You activated my trap card.
Stop it. Get some help.
My man Hook was like, "Oh hell no!" He's like, "I don't give a fuck about your curses, bro. Get out of my way." And then he just walked out. Danhausen was sitting there like,
"Nope.
Why my curse didn't work?" He was like, It's not working. It's not working." Oh, that was funny. Funny stuff. Then we have Swerve versus The Revolution is Televised. Absolute Ricky Starks. This was one hell of a match. With the assist from Will Hobbs, Swerve loses, and Ricky Starks gets the win. Good to see Ricky Starks winning. It's okay to be Swerve. He'll be fine. He's not buried. He's okay. They protected him, even though he still lost. Like I said, Starks hit his finisher. After that, Keith Lee came down to break up Team Taz's celebration, and we will get Lee and Swerve versus Hobbs and Stark very, very soon. Definitely looking forward to that. So, guys, that was your AEW Dynamite. That was your Dynamite. Why I keep saying Dynamite?
You stupid.
That was your Rampage. That was your SmackDown. And that was your Triple H. So, I hope everything is okay in regards to Triple H. And I hope he continues to get well. And we had a good Rampage. And we had a SmackDown that was... They really need to get better at promoting, at doing what they do on these shows. As for that, that's all I got. Listen, it's your boy, RJD here. I am out, but check out my socials.
You activated my trap card.
As always, like, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel. I am out. Peace.